God bless you. And I want to say Happy New Year,
yes,
2022, to my Greater Love Temple church family and to everyone who is watching. May the blessings of the Lord be upon you. We are unable to assemble at the temple today due to an outbreak of COVID-19 within our congregation. But thank God, no one has been hospitalized or become deadly ill from this outbreak. God is good, and His mercy endures forever.
Amen.
As I preached on last week, obey God, take warning, and get out of harm's way, and you shall survive.
Amen.
You shall survive. We are going to be obedient to the Word of God because God wants us to survive and be a witness for Him. We are all aware of this new variant of COVID-19 called Omicron, in which medical science has told us it is more contagious and easier to spread than the Delta variants. So I'm going to say to the members at Greater Love Temple and those who are watching, when you begin to feel some of the symptoms of this virus, please go and get tested to help reduce the spreading of this virus. I am praying and asking God in the name of Jesus,
yes,
to please help us. For I believe in His time, God will handle COVID-19 and make everything all right. But until then, God expects us to be obedient to the laws of the land and follow the guidelines that have been established for COVID-19. And remember, when we obey God and take warning and get out of harm's way, we shall survive.
Mm-hmm.
We know that at the beginning of a new year, a lot of New Year's resolutions are made. So for a few moments, I want to talk about the right way to make a New Year's resolution. What is a resolution? A resolution is a firm decision to do or not to do something. Simply put, a plan of action. Now, there is nothing wrong with planning or making resolutions. But according to the Word of God, there is a right way. We should do it. Deacon Moore, please read.
Sure. Reading from James chapter 4, verses 13 through 17, I'll be reading from the New International Version. Now, listen. You who say, today or tomorrow, we will go to this or that city, spend a year there, carry on the business, and make money.
In these scriptures, James, the half-brother of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and a leader in the church in Jerusalem, is speaking to the people about their plans, resolutions for the future. Read, Deacon Moore.
Why, you do not even know what will happen tomorrow. What is your life?
James says, you are making these plans for the future, And you don't even know if there will be a future.
Right.
What is your life? Read, Deacon Moore.
You are a mist that appears for a little while and then vanishes.
The King James Version says, "For what is your life? A vapor that appeareth for a little time and then vanishes away." The word vapor means a mist, an exhalation, a smoke. Such a vapor as we see ascending from a stream or as lies on the mountainside on the morning, or as floats of a little time in the air, but which is vanished by the rising sun, leaving not a trace behind. What this means is that a person can be here 1 second and gone the next. Deacon Moore, continue reading.
Instead, you ought to say, if it is the Lord's will, we will live and do this or that.
James is now stating the right way, a plan, resolution should be made. When making a New Year's resolution or any plans, we should always say, if it is God's will, I am planning to do this or that. For no one knows the future but God.
Amen.
Therefore, if you are planning to do something that is right, something that is right, you should always say, God willing.
God willing.
Before you state your plans. Deacon Moore, continue reading.
As it is, you boast in your arrogant schemes. All such boasting is evil. If anyone then knows the good they ought to do and doesn't do it, it is sin for them.
The Word of God lets us know that when we do not say, if it is God's will, it shows just how arrogant we are with boasting about what we're planning to do.
Right.
In which we don't even know if we're going to see the next moment. As James says, all such boasting is evil. It's evil. Did you get more ready?
Amen.
And now, since you have heard the right way to make plans, resolutions, and you don't do it, you have sinned. Now, this is the Word of God.
Amen.
And I'm sure there have been many who have made New Year's resolutions who have not said, if it is God's will. But thank God for His Word.
Amen.
That is here to correct and help us to learn the way of the Lord so that we can be obedient children.
Amen.
For there is a blessing in obeying the Word of God. Deacon Moore, would you like to wish everyone a happy new year and encourage them to always say, God willing,
amen,
when making plans or resolutions?
Sure. First of all, I just want to say I want to give honor to God, to my bishop, too, here, But you know, to everyone, I definitely want to wish a happy new year. Happy new year. And just want to thank God for bringing us into a new year. And to always remember, especially coming to 2022, especially now that he's brought us this far, for those that are listening and watching, when you do say something, or when you make some type of resolution, or when you decide you want to do something, or take some trip, or do whatever, just always say, God, if it's your will, let that take place. And then when you say that, you have to understand and really mean that, because if it's his will, and it doesn't happen, you can't get upset. You have to say to yourself, God, if that's your will for me not to go, then that was your will, and I will accept that. So whenever you're doing anything, whenever you're going anywhere, whenever your kids are going anywhere, when you're on the highway, always pray and always say these words, is God, if it's your will, make sure you bring them back safely. God, if it's your will, take me here and there safely. Because that's what we're going to need. And we have to trust God, because it was God's will that he brought us through this whole pandemic right now. So we have to always put that first whenever we do anything. And if you do that, you will have a wonderful year. Because if it's God's will for you to have that, you will have that. So happy new year. And remember, if it's God's will, things will take place the way it's supposed to take place. Because that's what he wants it to take place.
Thank you, Deacon Moore. In our conclusion, I want to say again, Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
And there is nothing wrong with making the right resolutions for a better life.
Amen.
In which we know the best life is with Jesus Christ.
Amen.
But when you are planning anything, you should, according to the Word of God, always say, if it is God's will. And when you do it God's way, he shall be pleased, and you shall be blessed.
Amen.
Deacon Moore, let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, God, we say thank you for letting us see another year.
Amen.
God, we thank you for how you kept us from danger seen and unseen in 2021. No one knows what the future will be, but you, God, for 2022. But God, we thank you for your word. Your word tells us we can plan to do the right thing. We can plan to go places. We can plan to enjoy this life. But we must always say, if it is your will. For we know whatever your will is, it shall be done. For your will is right and good. Good and right. All the time. And we say thank you for your will, God. Your perfect will. Your permissible will, things that you allow. Though sometimes they may not always make us feel good. But your word has taught us that all things work together for the good of them that love you, God, and are called according to your purpose. And we say thank you. Father, we pray right now that those that are ill with this variants of this COVID-19, God, we pray that you would touch them. Raise them up, God, in the name of Jesus. God, we thank you, God, for technology, that even though we're not able to be at the temple today, through technology, we can still present your word to those that have a listening ear. God, we pray right now that the love through your son Jesus will spread throughout the world. That people will come to know you through your son Jesus Christ. Just how much you love them. Just how much you want them to be with you forever. God, we say thank you for your love. God, bless us. Keep us, God, in your tender, loving care. And we will forever give your name the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you for watching. And I want to say again to my Greater Love Temple Church family, due to this new variants of this virus, we're going to take it 1 week at a time. If God say so, we will resume at the temple on next week. If not, again, we thank God that through technology, I am still able to give you a word from the Lord. Let's be mindful. Let's listen to the scientists. Take warning. And get out of harm's way so that we can survive and be a witness if God allows us. In 2022 for our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. God bless you. Heaven smiling until we meet.